Lidia Thorpe's royal outburst at Parliament House has reverberated around the world, UK media especially losing its collective mind. But has the Senator's controversial move achieved exactly what she hoped for?
It was all going off without a hitch. King Charles and Queen Camilla's tour so mindful, so demure. Until... Independent Senator Lidia Thorpe calling out the King during a parliamentary welcome yesterday. Cue international outrage.
An unexpected colonial confrontation.
The King has been heckled by an Australian ingrate.
It's a very crowded field, but she has the gold medal for being the most ludicrous and embarrassing politician in the Commonwealth.
You are a genocidalist. This is not your land. Strong stuff.
Overnight, UK Prime Minister Keir Starmer defended his King, saying...
Look, I think the King is doing a fantastic job. An incredible ambassador, not just for our country, but across the Commonwealth.
The Senator's comment putting the British government under pressure over historical colonial wrongs.
The government's position on this has not changed. We do not pay reparations. We won't be offering an apology at Chogham.
Back home, the blow-up showed no signs of dying down, with calls today for Senator Thorpe's resignation.
There's a very strong argument for somebody who doesn't believe in the system but's willing to take $250,000 a year from the system to resign in principle.
Look, it was pretty disrespectful.
We're embarrassed across the globe as a result of this.
Others more forgiving.
Her messages are her messages, but I think it's a complex history with the King that we need to understand, and the country still needs to heal from the past.
She's raising a really important issue. I think there is a time and place, though.
Senator Thorpe, unfazed by the reaction, doubling down on UK TV.
I'm not fussed about what people say about me. I will continue to fight for justice for my people. We are the real sovereigns in this country. The King is not our sovereign.
So with the conversation about treaty and reparations now on the global stage, has Lidia Thorpe helped or hurt the Indigenous cause?
We're live from the lands of the Kulin Nation, and Dan Bourchier is an ABC journalist and Indigenous affairs analyst with connections to the Yorta Yorta people. Dan, thanks so much for being with us. What do you make of Senator Thorpe's actions?
Good to be with you. I think that Senator Thorpe was clearly trying to make a point, one that she's consistently made over the last couple of years since she joined the federal Senate, but in fact is a point that she's made for decades around treaties and also about the broader treatment of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people. And certainly from the comments we've seen from Senator Thorpe today, she's not stepping away from that and saying that this, in fact, was her version of truth-telling on the global stage and that this is about having a conversation that she says is absolutely crucial right now.
Dan, that's an interesting interpretation of the way that Lidia Thorpe goes about garnering attention for her causes. To some, it looks like her cause is about her. Do you know what I mean? So do you think it's done more to help or harm the cause?
It's hard to know what will pan out as a result of this, but one thing that's crystal clear right now is that the world is talking about this. There have been news bulletins being led with this very incident and this event right across the planet, and for the first time we're having a truly global conversation about the issues that Senator Thorpe raised. But of course that's not to say that this is broadly or widely agreed to by everyone, and certainly not all Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people in Australia, because there are a wide and varied range of views and perspectives on this very matter, but also about the way in which these issues are communicated to those who are in authority and more broadly.
You mentioned there's a range of responses from within the Indigenous community. Can you take us through those?
Yeah, well, the range of views is as varied as the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander population. You have Aunty Violet Sheridan, a respected Ngunnawal elder. She was at the event. She was sitting on the stage behind the King and the Queen, and she was very strong. She said that Senator Thorpe does not speak for her and her people. We've then also heard from former Senator Nova Peris, who was, of course, the co-chair of the Republican movement, who said that she is disappointed that this was an outburst. And she went as far as saying that she she was sorry to the King and the Queen. And then on the other hand, we've heard from Vanessa Turnbull Roberts, for example, who's a Bundjalung woman, and she's the ACT's inaugural Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander Commissioner for Children and Young People. And she has said that Senator Thorpe is a leader and really backing in those comments and doubling down on those calls for treaty. And we are seeing two really clear groups, those who are saying that this is not the forum to be having this conversation, and those who are saying that you have to take any avenue to have that conversation. And of course, that's what we're doing right now. We're talking about this and the impact of those comments and what that means going forward.
Dan, thank you so much for taking the time tonight.
Oh, my pleasure. Thanks for having me.